Hi, I'm Judith, the time traveler, and this is my lifestyle time travel blog. Today, we are talking about the greatest archaeological discoveries of the year 2022. This is our list of top 9 biggest discoveries this year. Some of them are just interesting and some of them will blow your mind. Number 9. Egyptian tunnel. This tunnel was all over the news during November and it was discussed as a pathway to the discovery of the tomb of Cleopatra. It was found beneath a temple of Osiris in Temple of Osiris Magna in Egypt, that is near Alexandria. This structure is magnificent and in Egypt it is one of a kind. Another tunnel that looks like this was found at the island of Samos and it is called the Tunnel of Epulainos. And this tunnel was actually an aqueduct. So some archaeologists say that this tunnel that was found in Egypt could lead to Cleopatra's tomb. But could it really? It was found beneath a temple and Egyptian royalty was never buried under temples. They had their own designated tombs in necropolis. And we have never found the tomb of a Ptolemaic royalty, so we do not know how they actually looked like. But probably they were not located outside of Alexandria. But they are now probably submerged underwater in Alexandria. So even though this tunnel is a huge discovery, the probability of it leading to Cleopatra is slim. Number 8. Gobekli Tepe. This site has been excavated ever since the middle of the 90s and it is famous for its temples. Those circular structures with T-shaped limestone pillars that have human and animal representations. And these round temples were built around 9000 years BC. But up until recently, no domestic structures have been found, which has changed in the recent past. And during this year, archaeologists have discovered even more of these domestic buildings. These houses that were found this year come from the early pre-pottery Neolithic B, which is some 7000 years BC. They are rectangular buildings with stone walls that were preserved up to 2.5 meters. They have limestone floors, limestone features, they have hearths, they have benches, limestone vessels, grinding stones, everything you need for everyday life. And probably they had flat roofs, so people communicated by roofs or they just spent time and performed some activities on rooftops. And one house that was found this year comes from the middle or late pre-pottery Neolithic B, which may seem boring, but this means that this settlement lived way longer than previously thought. Number 7. Wine with vanilla in Jerusalem. 11-story jars were found in Babylonian destruction layer in Jerusalem, and that destruction layer can be dated to 586 BC. So these jars were analyzed, and 5 of them had resent stamps on their handles of Kingdom of Judah's royal economy. This might also seem unimportant, but in those jars, wine was found. But not just any wine, wine with vanilla. This vanilla flavored wine doesn't tell us only about the preferences of the Judas elite, but also about trade. Because you see, vanilla was not a local product, it had to be imported from somewhere. And where is that somewhere? Probably India or East Africa. So they made a huge effort to get that vanilla and they used Saudi Arabian desert roads. And trading goods, including spices, were transported in desert caravans. So to get this vanilla in wine, you had to pay a lot and to be a really important figure. Number 6. Mysterious origin of Bronze Age gold. In this analyze, 61 pieces of golden jewelry were analyzed and they all date from the early Bronze Age, which is 2500 to 2000 years BC. And these pieces of jewelry include Priam's treasure from Troy, jewelry from the royal tombs of Ur, from Polyochnion Lemnos, and jewelry from Georgia. And the results are in and they say that all of this gold came from the same source. probably a secondary source, which is a river, but we still don't know where that exactly was. We do know that in Mesopotamia there were no natural sources of gold. And how to know if the gold came from the same deposit? Each deposit has its own fingerprint. So a specific gold has certain amounts of silver, zinc, or copper, or other metals. So based on the percentage, you can tell if it all came from the same source or not. And this jewelry was probably mass-produced, as the same design was found at different sites. So here we have an example of a widespread Bronze Age trading routes and contacts between different cultures. Number 5, the domestication of cats. For quite some time, we've known that cats were domesticated in the Near East during Neolithic, some 10,000 years ago. But this new study that was published during November is revealing much more about cats. And this ongoing project is studying the emergence of cats in Europe. So the early domestication of cats had something to do with the emergence of house mice. And they probably domesticated by themselves. They just came and saw humans as food source. Not that they ate humans, but they saw remains of human food and those mice that lived in their house as an easy source of food. So all of the cats were domesticated from the Near Eastern wildcat. And in this study, we see that we have remains of these Near Eastern wildcats even during the Neolithic of the Southeast Europe in the Danube Gorges. But later cats were domesticated again during the ancient Egypt. So Etruscan, Phoenician and Greek sailors and traders brought cats to Europe, including Rome, and then the Roman legionaries spread them further all over Europe. And you get a cat, and you get a cat, and you get a cat. But the cats were not that numerous in Europe until the second half of the 13th century. So we still don't know a lot about cats, but we are expecting new results and more information soon. Number 4. Nazca child sacrifice and psychoactives in Peru. Nazca is a pre-Hispanic South American culture, and this study was trying to shed a new light to Nazca rituals. Hair that was naturally preserved in these mummies was analyzed to see if those people consumed some psychoactives before their demise. So one head gave us some interesting results. The child that was sacrificed consumed psychoactives before the execution. Remains of San Pedro cactus were found in this hair. And San Pedro is a source of mescaline. San Pedro is usually consumed as a beverage. Mescaline causes a hallucinogenic state related with auditory and visual alterations, ego dissolution and synesthesia. So this child was previously drugged, then executed as a part of a ceremony. And we also know that one woman that was also sacrificed chewed coca leaves before her death. And this is really interesting because usually trophy heads belong to male adults that were collected during warfare. So now we have more information about Nazca ritual sacrifices. Number 3. Bronze statues from San Casciano dei Bagni. And this year more than 2 dozen perfectly preserved bronze statues were found. They're all more than 2,000 years old. And they were found in hot mud and waters of an ancient sacred pool. And this was all located inside of a temple. This temple was built during the 3rd century BC by the Etruscans, and later on, Romans continued using it. And it was famous for its healing properties as it was located next to a hot spring. The Etruscans built this temple with marble pool, with fountains and altars. And altars that were found were dedicated to Apollo, his son Asclepius, and his daughter, so Asclepius' daughter, Hygieia. So Etruscans adopted Apollo from Greeks, then Romans continued worshipping this god. So the Romans enlarged this temple, they decorated it more, and it was one of the favorite destinations of the Emperor Augustus. And even though there was a sacred pool, nobody except the religious figures could bathe in it. But others, the sickly, could come here to offer help from Apollo and his offsprings to grant them help. So they were making offerings to these gods. And those offerings usually included bronze figurines. And to pinpoint which part of the body needed recovery, they offered figurines in shape of body parts to these gods. So the archaeologists found small figures, small models of body parts like ears or feet or torsos with organs. But this year, 24 perfectly preserved anthropomorphic statues were found, and they included a statue of Hygieia with a serpent wrapped around her arm, a statue of a young boy or Ephebe, and human heads, and you get the point, anthropomorphic statues that were larger in size. And probably there was a business going on in this temple. There was a blacksmith that could make you a statue or a figurine of a thing you wanted to offer to the god, so the body part or the whole statue. And the runner-up this year is a Neolithic shrine in Jordan. This shrine is dated 9,000 years ago. This shrine was found in a campsite that was located near large structures that were used for corralling gazelles for slaughter. And these structures were called desert kites. So they were made from one or several large stone walls that ended up in an enclosure where they could gather the gazelle and kill them. So these people were actually specialized in gazelle hunting. And in this shrine that was made from stone, two large upright stones with anthropomorphic features were found, and one of them had representations of this desert kite. Also in this shrine we have a heart, we have an altar, we have marine shells, and a miniature model of the desert kite. And on the first spot we have the oldest cooking fire in the world. We are using fire even today to prepare our food, but so did our ancestors. At the site of Gesher Benot Yaakov in Israel, a heart-related hominin activities together with remains of freshwater fish were found, and they are dated to 780,000 years ago. So we do have earlier evidence of fire that date back to 1.2 million years ago in Kenya, the site of Kobifora, but we do not have animal or food remains related to this fire activity. So this is actually the oldest evidence of cooking so far. Thank you for watching this video, and write down in comments which discovery was your favorite. And of course, you know what to do, like, subscribe, share, send to all, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!